Welcome to week 15 of the Madden 08 PC version, 1986 historical franchise. Today my Colts are going against the Minnesota Vikings, and the Vikings have a very good team led by two defensive linemen. They have Chris Dolman, defensive end, Keith Millard, defensive tackle. On offense, Tommy Kramer quarterbacking, Anthony Carter as a wide receiver. They have Darren Nelson, running back. Scott Studwell, middle linebacker. Excuse me. They have some very good, very talented players. From the two. They come in at 6-7. Number 21 returns this one. Not quite out of the playoff picture, but they've got some work to do. I expect this to be a very tough game. I did go ahead and get into the settings, and I moved everything across the board as far as computer AI to 75.
Launching the pass deep down the right side. Gets his hand up. Looking for something big on first down, but the pass off the mark. Call this defense here.
Second and 10. Now, Anthony Carter at this time, I want to say they caught him the wizard. He's their number one receiver, but I don't think he's a dominant number one just yet.
Here comes the blitz. Steps up.
Oh, good blitz by Bickett. Darren Nelson's a pretty good little running back, but he could not come over and pick up the blitz on that one.
Especially when they blitz. What you have to do is read the play quickly, recognize the blitz, and get it out of there to your hot receiver quickly. You can't take too long to get it out of there.
Jordan comes in motion.
Jordan tight end. He's a very high-rated tight end on this game. Steve Jordan. Very good player. I left him out. And that's kind of surprising because they have some pretty good offensive linemen. Gary Zimmerman's up there.
This is a good special teams play.
I figured this game being in their home stadium, just out of the playoff picture, I figured that'd be really tough this week.
Fair catch made. Strength versus strength here today, John. One of the top running backs in the league against one of the dominant run-stopping teams.
This is like some classic heavyweight fight. I bet we won't know who the winner is till the last round.
Okay, empty backfield. Dickerson split out.
Lines up with five wide receivers. Pass play here on first down. Launches it across the middle.
I'm not sure where I'm going with that one.
Nearly picked it. Close to a big play by the defense.
And it probably should have been a big play. He had perfect position to get the interception. He just dropped it.
Hate when that happens. Try to get my interior guys going out toward the corners.
The lone back drops back. Closing in.
Come on.
The offensive line just
I was doing my best to push the button on that one.
They have to keep their shoulders square, keep their inside foot up, and they're going to get beat again and again.
And I apologize for that coughing. I'm doing my best to get rid of it. But
a lot of speed on the field for the defense as they line up in the quarter. A little misdirection. Number 55.
Crud.
There for the tackle.
Get on the outside.
Now, smart coach would punt the ball here.
Three plays. They lost yardage. Here comes the punter. And he chooses not to return this one.
Fair catch made at the 17-yard line. Try this play. The Vikings will start the drive at the 17-yard line. First and 10.
One back. Yeah, you see.
Only one man back. Looking for something long.
Double coverage. Fulcher's back there. Oh, good move. Good move. Go, 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 go.
The 20. The 10. 5. Dives. Touchdown.
Boom, son. Oh, and we killed Anthony Carter in the process. Man, I hope this game does not crash.
You better kick it here.
David Fortier, leading league in interceptions, and just returned one for a pick six. Broke like two tackles on the play. Three tackles, piled a guy out.
The defense will probably be looking to jump another pack, so I wouldn't be surprised to see a stop and go route. With a good pump,
that move right there makes me look like a pretty good little GM. My linebackers haven't really paid off as much as I'd like them to so far, but you know, they are the backbone of my defense. But now Fortier, he's supposed to be my enforcer. I didn't really expect him to get the interceptions he has, but I think that was his eighth on the year.
Number 51 is there on the stop at the 32.
Give this defense a shot.
We're reporting out on the injured player. The team
broke his finger.
It's the type of injury that will take some time to heal.
That is sad.
Gets rid of it.
Almost another one.
Was his intended target. The 34
on the cover. I'd like to see Fortier end up with at least 10, as close as he is. Double digits on his interceptions in season one.
To carry it. Great fake. Gets the pass off, and the catch is made. Daniel comes up to make the play at the 48.
You should stop him with this play.
First and 10. Ball on the 48-yard line.
Let's go, Beatrice.
Nelson, the lone back. Pressure coming. Gets rid of it. And he hits his target.
Good play by Jordan going up in front of the defenders to get that one.
Here's a good defense for this situation.
Ball on the 41-yard line.
41-yard line.
Stay both now. Watch the man. Whip.
Roll it. He finds his man. Daniel comes up to make the play at the 31. The defenders unable to stop them, giving up three straight first downs all through the air.
The thing is, the offense is chewing up yards every time they're going back to pass. This drive is going to end up with a touchdown if they keep doing that.
He tucks it away. Setting up play action. Gets the pass off. This pass is incomplete.
Yeah, he put his helmet in there, and he made contact.
That would have been a tough catch to make. He had it for just a second. The guys came in, sandwiched him up a little bit, and then he dropped it. I'm kind of surprised, especially with the injury to Carter and the fact that the score is kind of low, you know, not a big lead, that they are not using Darren Nelson more. Nelson's an explosive back. I figured they would rely a little more on him. Instead, choosing the, well, Kramer's getting killed back there. This is the best pass rush we've had in a couple games. The Minnesota faithful are not happy with it.
Is the deep return man. No return here. That's what comes to the 20. We've reached the end of the first quarter, and the score is 7-0. Colts.
I'm not real sure what I'd have done there. In that position, I don't think I'd have punted, or I'd have punted straight up in the air. Just one of those high booming punts to try to down it inside the 20. Looks like they're doubling both of the outside guys. May get Mac coming out. Dickerson,
the
run, big boy, run. Are you serious?
Oh,
that was safety caught him.
That's the kind of play that really gives the offense a lot of confidence out there.
39. No, doesn't look like 39 is a safety.
Dropped in the backfield for a short loss.
They didn't fool anybody with that play call. The defense knew what was coming, and they shut that thing down quickly.
It's second down and a long way to go. They line up in the I formation with a counter play.
I thought for sure when he caught that going across and broke the first tackle, he'd had a touchdown out of it.
If they can get it to the 16-yard line, that would be
a wrong play. Yeah.
Indianapolis calls a timeout. They have two timeouts remaining. If they can get it to the 16-yard line, that would be a first down.
We'll look for Beach across the middle. First read. Looks like safety's coming up. If he doesn't back out, Beach should be open. Go ahead and send Hester on a slant. And Brooks going deep.
They'll bring the blitz. Going deep. The defenders got it. The Colts get the safety.
If you could see me, I'm sitting here shaking my head. I'm not happy. Not happy with this throw at all. And I'm fortunate I got bailed out with the positioning of the interception and gave me a safety out of it. But totally not happy with that.
From the 20-yard line.
I think that's one of the instances that rule has been changed. If you catch it there and your momentum carries you into the end zone, I think, again, if I'm remembering right, if your momentum on an interception carries you into the end zone, you can down it and get a touchback. Because there's really nothing the defender can do there, and I'm not sure that he caught it outside of the end zone. That's one I would have challenged, whether I won or lost it.
Number 55 dishes out punishment at the 42.
They are destroying my blocking, and it's not even close.
Great job getting in there. He was looking for the run before they even snapped the ball.
Oh, come on.
And that's now three tackles for him in this game. He blew right through the defense.
The offensive line dominated the defensive line there, and they sprang the runner.
They'll bring the blitz. Hit and sack.
Had him wide open.
A lot of big plays are made.
Perfect call.
You also got to give credit to this coordinator because he's the one who puts his guys in position to make the plays.
Perfect call. Wide open. And missed him.
Gets the ball off. Browner comes up to make the play at the 35.
Here's where it pays off to have a receiver that can get open quickly. You try and match him up one-on-one and let him do his thing to get you a first down.
We'll report now on the injured player. The team is indicating it's the type of injury that...
I'm going to try to get Beach. Now, this is a play action, so I have to be fairly quick. Beach or Hester coming across the right side.
Hand off to the tailback. Play action. Rowing. And he makes the grab. Number 21. He's there on the...
And I probably had both of them, but if I have my choice of the two, I'm going to go Hester all day long. I like Beach, but Hester's more reliable, more explosive.
Hand it off to the back. Number 55 is there for the tackle at the 9-yard line.
I think that's Studwell.
Needs to make a big play. Maybe they bring some heat with a blitz or they change up the cover. That way they can force the offense into making a mistake and keep them from getting any points before the half.
It's second and goal at the 9. The backs are lined up in a 9. Throws it. He hits the receiver.
Oh, no.
The Vikings.
The ball carrier always has to keep a firm grip on the ball. But when his team is deep inside the enemy territory, the worst thing you can do is fumble down here.
Oh, my gosh. Yeah, he may be punching his ticket out of town. I know I've alluded to that earlier, so that lets you know at least I'm thinking about it. In fact, he's going to lead the league in fumbles, and it's not going to be... I don't think second place is going to be very close. He's a very dynamic player, but you've got to hold on to the ball. Okay, looks like they're just trying to run the clock down. If I stop them without them getting a first, I'll call timeout. And remember, I had to burn one earlier when I select the wrong play. There we go, there we go.
Their defense just gave them the ball on the takeaway, but then they give it right back.
Kind of weird, isn't it, Al?
It's first and goal at the 9-yard line, and it appears this one is going to be looked at.
Yeah, and because it's in the last 2 minutes, that ball came down from the replay booth.
The coach is hoping to get it right here because that could be a big.
It looks like the ground caused it, but I don't think his knee was down.
It's tough to say with that replay. This one won't be easy.
Yeah, his knee's down.
The trail was down before the fumble occurred.
The guys upstairs made the right call as the referee overturned the call and got it right.
Yeah, and it's important to get the calls right in these last 2 minutes.
It's very important. You tell him, John. And because of the excitement about the fumble, I didn't call timeout. And they're happy. You know, content going to halftime down 9-0. Which is a little shocking considering they get, you know, they have to kick it off at the beginning of the half. Let's see if we can get Verdon doing something. He's been quiet the last couple of weeks returning the ball. Straight up the gut. Oh, you dirtbag. If Mullen Guy hadn't come back and hit me, I'd have had a touchdown.
Sends their offensive unit back onto the field. Ball on their own 40. They'll
start the drive at the 40-yard line. First and 10.
Fakes off, man. It's off.
Gives the ball off. Fakes the handoff. Rolling out to his right. Throwing on the run. Harris comes up to make the play. That's a 38. You can't draw it up any better than that. Textbook first down. Ball on the 38-yard line.
Ball on the 38-yard line.
Pretty much in field goal position if we don't mess it up. I'm not big on field goals, but if... And I thought I was doing a run right there.
Drags him down behind the line. Great play from the defensive
end. Continuous the trees I'm up to. I feel like I do a lot better as far as selecting plays and not making mental mistakes when I'm not doing the commentary.
Andy's ridden out at the 31.
A solid running game starts with a blocking of the offensive line. The ball carrier must have good vision.
Trying to get Brooks on the slant there. I got a little bit deeper slant, not really a quick slant.
With the throw, and it's caught. Howard is there for the tackle at the 18. Number 10 is right on the mark with that throw.
Third down is when you really need your quarterback to be sharp because of temptation.
Trying to get Boyer. Let's get Boyer for a touchdown. Hopefully he'll sneak right between the safeties back there. And lob it up. Go get it, big boy.
Watch this catch by the tight end. I always say the tight end is.
Let me make sure I got it over the
red zone. He's a big target.
Looks like the linebacker's head.
Caused matchup problems for the defense.
Almost lofted it too high, too slow.
You should go for two.
No. Well, I'll go ahead. Because 15, 16 wouldn't really help me. Okay, going to do the run. Try to pinch it in. Nope.
The two-point try is no good. Number 11 is just about ready to kick this one away.
Number 21, back to return.
Should be a return here. From the 7.
Been a rough start to this game, but they still have enough time to turn it around. Try this ball here.
First and 10.
We'll start the drive at the 26-yard line. First and 10.
I'm really surprised at how dominant we've been and how easily we've manhandled their offense.
He threw it okay, just to the wrong guy. He's got to hang in there a little bit longer. so he can make a better read when he feels the pressure from the blitz.
Caught me off guard there, Sam Mills. Sam Mills is sort of in the Defensive Rookie of the Year for the AFC. Sort of in there, in talks. Trying to spin back. He was toward the low end of that.
But there are a lot of last time I looked, successful running game. You got to have good play calling, good blocking up front.
He's having a very solid year.
Second and maybe three.
But seems like the defensive rookies are performing better than offensive rookies during this 86 franchise. My tight end got jammed up in the middle. Couldn't break free.
You really have something special.
He now has two sacks. They have to get it now to at least a 19-yard line.
Okay, I'm going
to
look Brooks and
come out in a nickel pack.
Hester. Where's Beach? Go ahead and send him straight up the middle.
Getting some air under this one, looking for his man. He almost intercepted.
Should have lobbed that one.
Which is what the defense should have had on that play. You better kick it here.
49 yards.
This will be a long field goal attempt, about a 49 yarder.
Got it. Let's see if we've got the leg.
It's good.
Probably good from about 54, 55. We are indoors. This is the old Metrodome.
This one is handled by number 21.
Speaking of the Metrodome,
the Vikings need to rebound quickly.
Kirby Puckett.
This drive at the 22.
Kirby Puckett was my favorite baseball player growing up. You know, he was like Ant Dickerson in football. I like the Twins, and I love Kirby Puckett. He looked like he was about 5'5", and I mean, he was a stout guy, but he, you know, looked sort of, I don't say fat, but looked a little husky. But he could do it all. And I can still see the image of him on that plexiglass jumping up to rob a home run. I believe it was against the Braves, if I'm remembering right.
Line up in a five receiver set this time. Looks like
good old Kirby Puckett.
Let's start on the offense. Number 88. Still
number 88.
Down.
Moved a little early there.
They've got them all messed up.
Is, once you put your hand down, you can't move until the ball snaps.
Let's send Bickett.
Here we go. Hey, watch that three. I can do it, man.
Gets the pass off. This one falls incomplete. He appeared to feel the pressure there.
So many passing attacks in the NFL rely on timing.
Going all out.
Pressure on the passer, you never give him a chance to get into a rhythm. And you force him to throw the ball.
And I'm not sure if the Vikings here have Wade Wilson as a backup or not. I know they have Tommy Kramer starting. But now, like I said, I'm not sure if Wade Wilson's backing up or not.
Ball on their own 35.
Trying to get Dickerson up the sideline again. The last time I ran this, they had a busted play. No one was guarding him.
Looking for the deep pass down the right side.
I'll keep it in bounds. Are you kidding me?
There, he just put too much on.
Intended receiver on the play. Second and ten.
Two times.
Keep the throttle down.
To carry it, they'll go with a play fake. Rolls out to his left. Throwing. The wide receiver has it. Number 21 is there on the stop.
Gosh, that makes me mad.
When you have guys with speed that can get open downfield, it gives
and you I know, 18-0, dominating them.
All begins with the offensive line.
But gosh, you don't get wide open plays like that all the time.
Because it takes more time for the play to develop.
Picked up a few yards on the scramble, John.
He's one of those guys who's willing to run to make something happen. You have to be aware of that kind of
He's not willing to run, John Madden. I just messed up.
So we've reached the end of the third quarter with the Colts ahead of the Vikings 18-0.
I get so frustrated I don't even know what I'm picking sometimes.
It's second down and six to go.
Try to unleash Mack up the middle. Gosh, he's a beast.
Great run there. That'll be a first down.
He really ran well there. He gets some great blocks, and he has patience as he picks up the first down.
Dickerson, the deep man. Handed off to the fullback, number 75, is there for the tackle. Keeping it on the ground, they chose to run the same exact play, not even a shift in their formation.
Not even a shift.
Closing in on the move. And he hits his target. Touchdown, Colts.
Now, that was a different play than we ran earlier that got him open, but I don't know. With their defensive scheme, whatever they choose to run, they don't seem to be covering the back out of the backfield at all.
And it's 6 points. You better kick it here.
The point after is good. The Colts continue to increase their lead. Number 11 will be kicking off.
Number 21, back to return.
Now, if Trudeau keeps finishing strong the next couple of games like he's done the last couple,
it sure doesn't look like they're going to be able to come back in this one.
He could definitely propel himself into MVP talk, best quarterback talk.
Indianapolis comes out in their nickel package. Kramer with a man in motion. Pass play here on first down. Pressure coming. Going long. He's
good
there.
Throw.
Coleman is there on the stop at the 45.
Boom. This defense will stop.
Good
for
throw.
Sure.
I thought Mills was going to weep through the middle and get him, but.
Pressure. Throws it.
Somebody got their hands on him. And I believe it was 51, Pancake Mills. Fulcher looks like he's sneaking up.
They're coming with the blitz. Throwing it away. He couldn't find a receiver, so he threw it where no one could get it. Third down play. They have to get it to the 35-yard line for a new first.
We're treating this Minnesota offense like the real Minnesota defense treated Eli Manning last night.
Under pressure, throws it. It's batted away. He won the battle at the line of scrimmage and forced a bad throw.
Every quarterback needs a little time to look over the field. There we saw a defense who wasn't given any time at
this
all.
May be the best all-around defensive game we've played this year.
Won't take a chance.
I just really expected them to be so much tougher today.
First and 10. Ball on the 20-yard line.
Here we go.
The Vikings come out in a nickel pack. Receives the handoff. Number 56 is there for the tackle at the 20.
No gain on the play. Second and 10. Ball on the 20-yard line.
Then we're going to take it. Get it out. Be careful.
They line up in the I formation. Long throw. What a catch. Harris is there on the stop at the 46. The completion puts him over the 200-yard mark today.
I thought I might have Dickerson on that one. As I was dropping back, I noticed the guy that was covering Brooks kind of fell off. I thought they were in man, but it looked like zone. There was a gap to the outside left, so that's where I went with it. I was fortunate that it got there before the defensive back had time to go over and break it up.
2 minute warning coming up.
Ball on the 46-yard line.
Dickerson in the back with a counter play. Number 56 stops him for negative yardage.
Loss of four on the play.
We have about third and 15.
2 minutes to go.
Ball on the 50-yard line.
Minnesota looks like they're playing the pass as they're lined up in the dime. Great fake. Going deep and has a man wide open. Ball, he makes the catch anyway.
A gain of 24 yards that time. On third down. It's first and 10.
Ball on the 25-yard line.
Number 10, with slip pass. Rolls right. On the run. Caught out of bounds.
I'm not too upset with that. I mean, you're going to throw it where only your guy can get it.
The one they were trying to get the ball to.
Ball on the 25-yard line.
Keep moving.
Let him too far, but that's all right.
Number 58 is there on the stop.
I don't know that I like the split backfield to try to run it. I might be able to do this quick toss. I don't know anything quick about Mac, but
it's the toss to the right. Browner is there for the tackle at the 18. Fourth down upcoming.
I don't know, that play not terrible because the way the blockers kind of worked. I'm gonna try the same thing with Dickerson to the left, but the way it worked, they sort of flared out more to the outside, which allowed me to cut off their back. Got it.
Good call by the offensive coordinator. Looked like the defense was looking for something in the middle on that play.
Let's get Beach for a touchdown. Beach possibly looks like Bricks. So 3-1.
Closing in, this pass is incomplete.
Gritty pressure.
Well, let's get Trudeau killed.
They need to keep some extra blockers in, either a tight end on the line or a back that can help them out with their protection.
11th play of this drive.
Go with a Hester screen.
Hey, watch the screen.
Minnesota comes out in their nickel package. Steps up, gets the pass off, patted down at the line of scrimmage. Number 85 was the intended recipient.
Should have known better when I heard them say, watch the screen.
12th play of this drive.
Ball on the 15-yard.
I'm going to look for Mac. Right after he goes, breaks the line of scrimmage, over the top, inside of the safety.
Rolling right, looking long down the right side of the field. He's there for the catch.
Looks like a stop and go for him, Hester. No one was with him once he went. The cornerback may have thought he had over the top help from the safety, but no one was there.
You better kick it here.
Looked like Mac had about three guys surrounding him.
Comes in to attempt the point after. The point after is good. The Colts have it all working now as they continue to expand their lead.
Is lined up with a kickoff. Number 21 back deep to return.
Nice kick and returnable from the 5.
And we get the Raiders next week. The Raiders came into this week at 9-4, I believe. So they're definitely looking at a playoff spot, have a very good team.
This defense will stop them for sure.
I'm definitely looking forward to that one.
Ball on their own 34.
Ball on the 34-yard line.
I can do it, baby. They saw.
Probably a little dose of Marcus Allen, Todd Christensen.
This one falls incomplete. Time is working against them.
Yeah, I'm thinking they're going to keep going.
Jim Plunkett, I believe, is the quarterback. Howie Long on defense.
The Colts come out of the nickel pack. Joe, the motion man. Going for the deep man. He made the catch. Mill comes up.
I think Jones has caught a couple deep passes over the top, but they've not been able to capitalize.
Pressure coming, growing. Incomplete. Plenty of pressure, and he barely gets the pass away.
This defensive coordinator understands that pressure is the key to forcing the offense into making mistakes. If his players keep playing like this, he might be up for a head.
Sam Mills sack, force fumble, scoop and score.
Blitz is coming with the pass.
Daniel is there for the tackle. That's the 20. The Vikings call a timeout. They have one remaining. Davis returns to the game after being shaken up earlier.
We're talking about Rhea. Watch the play. There we go.
And the fans finally get to see their red zone offense. They'll bring the blitz. And this pass is completed.
I'm going to play tighter than that. Come on.
7-yard line. He's calling everyone up to the line of scrimmage.
Blue there.
The Vikings call a timeout. They have none remaining. 7 yards to go for the touchdown.
Our DBs were just giving way too much room.
Kramer back in the shotgun. Looks for the end zone. Comes down with a touchdown. Vikings.
This is a good play by the offense in the red zone. The wide receiver is going to break away right here and come up with a catch and a touchdown.
Too little, too late, but nice play, nice drive.
This is a good special teams play.
You know, if you're a coach, you're going to say momentum or a building block, something to go on for next week. But not much to be happy about today.
The point after is good. The Vikings still down by a bunch. Nelson comes in to kick off.
Number 89, back to return.
This one is handled by number 89. Number 89 finds an open area on the return and brings it back to the 30. First and 10.
Ball on the 30-yard line.
Play hard and fast, baby. Set it up. Alert, fire, fire. Left. Four. 64.
With the throw, complete to the running back.
I hate when they do that.
On the side, at the 18-yard line, number 10, stops the clock with that timeout. Ball on their own 18.
Throw the ball short, and then running back has to come back and get it. And gets killed.
Blitz is coming. Pressure throws on the move. It's batted away. This game reaches its conclusion with the
I had Verdon going across the middle. I accidentally hit the two button instead of the three.
This game is presented by the Authority of the National Football League and EA Sports. Any publication, rebroadcast, or other use of the descriptions and accounts of this game without the express written permission of EA Sports is prohibited. This is Al Michaels. Good night.
I think that last play took Dickerson under 100 yards receiving. Probably took Trudeau under 250. Kevin Mack looked good running the ball. Yeah, he's down to 95. He was up over 100. Armstrong, Davis, Broughton, Bickett, Mills, and Fulcher. Excellent. Very successful game. And like the rest of the weeks, we'll simulate through the rest of this week. Sim through the week. See what our matchup with the Raiders looks like. Raiders won this week also. Both teams kind of fighting for home field advantage through the playoffs. Should be a good matchup. Hope you enjoyed this game and look forward to the next one. Hope you join us, and we'll see you then.